Okay, so I've been doing makeup. Today, I started with Neutrogena oil-free moisturizer for my face. I picked the grapefruit one because those are the makeup wipes I've been using. Started there. Clean face, applied the moisturizer. Applied that before I started this so it's dry. Soaked in. And I use this hydrating face primer from e.l.f. because I just noticed I'm really dry, especially like through here and here. I'll get like flaky. I just switched my foundation like 5 times because of it. So I just use a moisturizer and a primer because of that. And then I guess I do my makeup kind of different than other people.
Can I be done?
Mm-hmm. Because I start with my face. I don't know, I've never been able to start with my eyes. I'm gonna go ahead and start. I've been using this Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 in the shade Ivory. It's a very full coverage foundation. So, definitely like covers up these bags you see I got going on, these zits. It even covers my freckles, which I like some days. But then I got in the sun and they're just right back. So, whatever. So, I always apply foundation with this foundation brush. And I'm kind of, I have like a light here and another me here, so kind of gonna be like not exactly looking at you guys. Excuse me. No. Because it is a pretty good color for me. But you know, you don't want the discoloration from your face to your neck. It's a little light. This is my winter color. But I don't really change color too much come summer because you know, it's pretty bad. So for me, I like, I don't know, I just feel like this works good. People do their own order of whatever. I do foundation, and then I do my eyebrows. So, let's see. So I've been using this Milani, soft brown, and it's a stay put brow color. Comes with its own brush. I really like this one because it stays like it's a stay put. It's serious. It really stays like the next morning if I don't wash my face before bed because I'm terrible and I do that frequently. It's still there. Maybe not like completely intact, but it's really good. So I always start by just like defining my eyebrow. Drawing the outlines here. I gotta be careful with this stuff because like I said, I love this stuff because it stays put. But if you put too much on the brush, it's like cakey. Or like, it's, yeah. So yeah, when I do that, which I kind of did that right here, I just like try to just smooth it out. So there's the outline of my brow. You can literally already see like a huge difference. I kind of try to do that whole like brush strokes to look like hair thing. I try, do, but like, it doesn't always work out for me. But I always like use my spoolie and like brush it in pretty well. So it's one, it's like not the best eyebrow, but it doesn't look super fake either. It doesn't look super boxy. Like, you can still see hair in there, you know what I'm saying? So I just kind of go up this way when I'm doing it, and then I like go more to the middle, and then like when I get to the arch, I'll just start going down, because that's kind of like how the hair flows. But oh my goodness, sisters, not twins, right? Tell this eyebrow to behave. Right, sisters, not twins. I always have one that's like Gucci and then like Walmart. Ugh. I can already tell this eyebrow is gonna be Walmart, so cool. Nothing against Walmart, I fucking love Walmart, but just in comparison. Okay, but like, you see the difference? I haven't like done the spoolie over here yet. Like, there's literal difference there. So do the spoolie, and then kind of just like touch up the marks that like look like they were missed. Okay, so there's them with my eyebrows, and then like maybe I'm weird for this too. And I will go to my powder. And I've been using just like this Maybelline Fit Me. It was on clearance, so I bought a couple of them, but I like it. It's the Fit Me 120 Classic Ivory Depressed Powder. I don't know, super weird that like I don't use the matching foundation and powder. But like when I found what works for me, and it works, I just like leave it like that. You know? It ain't broke, don't fix it. And I've gone through so many foundations because I moved and I was living in a state that was more humid. And I found like what's different. Like, I was living in Florida for a little bit, and oh my god, no, don't recommend it. I was like pouring sweat off my makeup all the fucking time. So, yeah. And I, like, had to find some stuff that was kind of good for there. It was, like, more lightweight, less full coverage. Because when, like, you go out with a full face and then you sweat your whole face off, what's the point? So I was going with something that was just, like, a little less coverage, but just even my complexion. And then I moved to Tennessee, and it was different. The weather was different there, too. So it was, like, getting really dry, and that's why I noticed like all the flaky through here. So I tried like 5 different foundations and combinations of primers and moisturizers to figure all that out, and Milani was the one that I discovered down there and liked the best. But my powder has always done me right. I'm not like really big on like certain brands or anything either, like just whatever works. Okay, so that's usually just like basic face foundation. Hey, relax.
What are you doing? Mom, can I do that with you?
Yeah, just hold on. Get your chair. So, my 3-year-old's gonna join us. She's makeup fiend. Okay, so then after my powder, again, I don't do this like other people, I guess, because I watch tutorials, I'm like, that's definitely not how I do it. I'm gonna just throw a little bit of to kind of cover these bags that are going on. A little bit of concealer. Oh, I'm using the Rimmel Stay Matte.
I'm gonna be right so I don't here really, since
brands aren't really like a big deal to me. I just like do what works. And then I'll just go ahead and there's a zit here and there was a zit here that we kind of saw. So I'm gonna cover those up. Hey, can you leave this way? Because I'm using that for light. Thank you kindly.
Can I use it too?
Yes, ma'am. So then, like, while I'm letting these sit.
Mom, can I have some of what you have on that and that?
You are gorgeous and you don't need foundation.
But, I want foundation.
But I will let you use some eyeshadow.
I want some foundation, please.
But you're so pretty without it. Let's not argue. I'm trying to record this, okay? Thank you. Okay, so then I'm just going to hang out with some friends. So I'm just gonna pick something kind of casual.
Mom, smooth that in.
This is my palette. It's Morphe 35F Fall into Frost. Looks like this. It's a little messy because my kids are constantly in my makeup. Right? Yeah, constantly. So I always start. I always start with like my crease. This is just like an everyday look for me. I'm not 100% fabulous at it. So start with this color. I don't remember what it's called because I had the plastic thingy on there to kind of help it, and my kids lost it. Go figure, right?
Mom,
like
what do you want to record?
Just in there. And I usually just start this and let this sit, which is weird, right? I don't know. Whatever. Okay. And then usually once I do that, I'm just gonna go ahead and dab it in. Use a makeup sponge. Come on.
Some of that you're using and batting in and tap and smoothing it in. Can I have that? Are you smoothing
it in? Sissy, wait a second, okay? Let me finish using it. Okay. Alright. This is my daughter. Okay, back up, please. You're beautiful. So then I usually go, I'm gonna go with, so I just do like a casual sparkle kind of on my lid.
Mom, you can use this light.
Yeah, I'm using this one though, so you can use it when I'm finished, all right? Thank you.
Mom, can I keep the recording?
Yeah. If you go find your phone, we'll record it on your phone. Okay.
Mom, where are you going?
I just do the lid kind of like that. Mm-hmm. Pretty simple.
Mom, where are you going?
Relax, honey. Nowhere yet, okay?
Just tell me where you're going.
We're going to go over to Uncle Scott's because it's his birthday.
Because I'm going over and Smash and TG.
No, no, no. Just me, you, and Sis. And then, like, I'm not crazy about eyeliners, really, anymore, too much. I usually just do eyeliner.
I like you.
Hey,
keep this.
Can I do this, please? Thank you. I usually only do eyeliner if... Go figure. If I am doing lashes to kind of cover up the strip of the lash. So I do eyeshadow on my waterline. But ever since I started doing it, I just like basically fell in love with it. So. Oh. Yeah. Okay, and then I am just going to, I don't contour because of my freckles.
Mom, can I use some of that while you're using
when I'm finished. I don't contour because of my freckles because I just feel like it looks weird. So I do just like bake a little under my eyes. And I'm using the e.l.f. HD powder. I'm going to always forget to show you guys myself before I use it. But.
Of your
right there, and then I kind of just do it here. Yes, Sissy. I just do that. And then I'll let that sit. Put that back. This is where we're at right now. I have thank you. I have a setting spray. There it is. I'm not gonna use it yet. Just getting everything ready so I'm not like looking for everything. So usually I just do this if I was gonna use waterproof mascara, which I'm not today because it's harder to get off. If I was gonna do waterproof mascara, I can't talk. I would apply my mascara right now while I was waiting for this to bake. But I'm going to use regular mascara. So I don't want to put that on before with setting spray or it's gonna like run everywhere. Okay, so I think that's enough for that. I'm gonna go ahead and brush that off so that we can go ahead and do some blush. I use the Maybelline Master Contour Kit. I might only really use the blush. This is for, what does it say? Light to medium skin. Just on the bottom. Because there's, you gotta wash between your back.
You should use your old one.
Okay, thank you. You gotta watch which one you buy because I accidentally bought the medium to dark, I think, one time. And it like was way too dark for my face. So go ahead and blush. I almost use blush as like a contour because that just works better for me. I don't know. I'm weird. I do what I like. It wasn't to work for my skin. So we'll go ahead and do that.
Mom, you're going to use this one.
Then we're going to go ahead when I'm finished. And then we'll go ahead and do some highlighter. Mimi picked out this highlighter, I guess. And this is Maybelline Master Chrome.
I'm going to pick that.
It's shade Molten Rose Gold. Clearly, I use that a lot.
But, I'm going to pick that.
So I just really do it here. I don't do a whole lot. So like I said, it's kind of like a, just like a friendly setting I'm going to. So we're not doing it, you know. Okay, now that all that is done.
You're gonna use.
The last thing I have to do is mascara. So before we do mascara, we're gonna do the e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Set. I'm kind of new to the powder that I use, the setting powder. And just the spray. I've never really used these. So I just kind of looked at some of them, looked at some reviews, and just picked one that wasn't too pricey. Just so I could test it out and see if it's something I like. Okay, so I'll go ahead and close your eyes. I'm supposed to spray, like, I don't know. It says how far, but 12 to 16 inches away. So I just kind of like almost like an arm length and just two sprays. The first couple times you use it, though, it definitely throws your face. You're like, shit, spray myself in the face. Okay. And then, not my favorite mascara because I love the,
I'm going to use that whole by myself.
Yeah. The Better Than Sex, but, I haven't been anywhere to buy it recently or ordered. I'm not really an online ordering makeup kind of person. I kind of like to go and do it. So I've been using the Maybelline Colossal because this is my favorite drugstore mascara by far. I've tried a couple of them and I like these kind of bristles versus like, I don't know. There's one that was like not so many bristles. I just like this one. No rhyme, no reason, I guess. I don't know. I just like this one. Like the way it does my eyes, so I'm gonna go ahead and apply that. I'm not gonna do falsies today. Just like I said, it's just like a low key kind of night. Stay, you know, we're supposed to be quarantined or whatever, so it's my my brother-in-law's birthday. So I'm just gonna go tell him happy birthday. I see my sister and brother-in-law. Because they help other watch my kids during this quarantine stuff, so it's not like I'm like breaking quarantine to go see them. They're people that I already see regularly. So I go ahead and So just do one coat, pretty good, right? And then I'll go to the other one and let that one kind of dry a bit. And I'll come back. Okay, so it's like one coat on each, and I'm like pretty okay with this look, you know, for like a low-key kind of thing or for like going to work, because like I don't need all that, but I'm just gonna keep going.
Mom, can you get this off? Pull things off.
Oh, yeah, hold on, give me 1 second. Excuse my face.
Well, I know I kind of like hang my mouth while I do my mascara.
I don't know, like it's the concentration thing. Ooh. Bless you. Total rookie mistake and got some mascara on my face. But we just dab the mascara right off. Get in my fixed. And then like my little secret, I don't know, I guess there's a thing that not a lot of people do. Because I did it in front of my friend, she was like, what? But no, you can't really see. I got a little bit of mascara right there. I just take that and I just like blend it in with this, because usually I do browns and oranges and stuff. So like when I blend some mascara in, that's enough. Bad. So, all right. So here is our finished product for just a chill night. My friend's brother-in-law, whatever. My sister's my friend. Okay, so here's our results. Satisfied. I do still have some bags on my eyes because, like, stress, kids, whatever reason. But satisfied with my makeup look today. I'll take a selfie and put it on the end of this once I, like, have some more stuff put together. That is my quick 20-ish minute face for just a chill night. I'll do a full glam probably soon. All right.